Hi there and welcome back. Let's review Ehlers-Danlos syndrome today, or EDS. We'll look into the EDS, what are the causes or the major types frequently encountered, how are we treating this syndrome, and bottom line, how do we underwrite. Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, or EDS, is a group of genetic connective tissue disorders characterized by unstable hypermobile joints, loose stretchy skin, and fragile tissues. So like Marfan syndrome, EDS is caused by a defect in the body's connective tissue. Unlike Marfan syndrome, the fragile tissues and skin and unstable joints found in the EDS are due to defects in a group of proteins called collagen, proteins that add strength and elasticity to connective tissue. So what are the major types? The first one is, or the most common form of EDS is Ehlers-Danlos hypermobility type, or also known as Ehlers-Danlos syndrome type 3 and EDS hypermobility type. Different literature gives different level. It is estimated that 1 in 5,000 to 20,000 people have EDS hypermobility type. It is characterized by loose joints and chronic or long-term joint pain. The exact cause of EDS hypermobility type is not known. However, a small percentage of the time it is believed to be caused by a change or a mutation in the TNXB gene called tenascin X. Most people diagnosed with EDS hypermobility type inherit it from a parent who also has the condition. It is an autosomal dominant condition, therefore only one parent needs to have a change in the gene that causes the disorder in order to pass it on. With each pregnancy, there is a 50% chance of passing it to the child. Diagnosis is based entirely on a clinical evaluation and family history. The clinical evaluation is done by a medical professional who looks for the major and minor criteria required to make the diagnosis. Genetic testing and prenatal testings are available on a limited basis for TNXB mutations, but only if the disease-causing mutation has been identified in a family member. The major diagnostic criteria are joint hypermobility, ability to bend your pinky finger backwards towards your wrist, passive dorsiflexion greater than 90 degrees, ability to push your thumb to your wrist, passive apposition, hyperextension of each elbow greater than 10 degrees, hyperextension of each knee greater than 10 degrees, ability to place the palms on the floor with the knees fully extended, soft skin with normal or only slightly increased extensibility. The minor criteria include positive family history of EDS hypermobility type, or family history of joint laxity, or without significant skin or soft tissue weakness, in a pattern consistent with autosomal dominant inheritance, recurrent joint dislocations, joint moves out of place, or subluxations, that is restricted movement of the joint, and chronic joint, limb, and or back pain. Other forms of the EDS can involve serious and potentially life-threatening complications. and these include vascular. So let's talk about vascular EDS, which can cause blood vessels to tear or rupture unpredictably. This can lead to internal bleeding, stroke, and shock. Vascular EDS is also associated with an increased risk of organ rupture, including tearing of the intestine and rupture of the uterus during pregnancy. Vascular EDS is also referred to as EDS type 4 and Sack-Barbara's syndrome. The exact prevalence of vascular EDS is not known. However, based on the number of affected people in the United States, it is estimated that 1 in 200,000 people have the condition. The gene that causes vascular EDS is the COL3A1 gene, or simply speaking, collagen type 3 alpha 1. The diagnosis of vascular EDS is based on an examination and identification of certain features and confirmation by lab testing. This testing may include DNA sequence analysis, deletion duplication analysis, and biochemical or protein-based testing. Genetic testing detects 98% of the changes in the gene for vascular EDS. The rest require more specialized tests. The median life expectancy for people with vascular EDS is 48 years. Make a mental note of this. Another classification is kyphoscoliosis form of EDS, which is associated with severe progressive curvature of the spine that can interfere with breathing. How about the treatment? Treatment helps manage symptoms and monitor for complications. Options include drugs, physical therapy, and sometimes surgery. How do we underwrite? As far as underwriting goes, follow the underwriting manual that your company expects you to follow and modify the final offer that you extend by following your internal company specifics. Okay, let's take a break. See you soon. Take care. Bye now.